Got him a dollar repenting, stop sinning before it's too many. Look, before it's too much. Time to switch it up, got the game in clutch.
Morning YouTube, it's your boy Jotty. We are back with another vlog.
I literally was just fucking around applying to jobs,
but I found this one. It's a Target job and there was no background check, at least for now. That's honestly the hardest thing with me getting a job is, bro, these background checks, like every job I've applied for, I have been declined. You guys don't even know this, but I applied for a job at Wegmans, which is like a big grocery store. It's this big ass grocery store. I had 3 interviews, bro. I had an over the phone interview and I went to the store for 2 interviews. I toured the store. I met with the bakery manager. Like they had me so deep into this process. And then I got a fucking email that they declined me because my background check. I was like, Jesus Christ, bro, how are you going to have me go this deep into this process? Like, why did they not just do the background check? Why did they waste my time, you know? And you know the most bullshit thing about this, bro, is I'm not even a convicted felon, right? But the thing is, it's worse when you have pending felonies than when you're convicted. Like, if I was a convicted felon, it would be like I already served my sentence, you know? Like, I already did what I had to. But since my charges are pending, you know, jobs look at it like, well, you still have to face that, you know? I still have to go to trial for that. So it's like they could lose me at any point, you know, because I could go to jail. All right, we're gonna try this job. This is a dog groomer at Pet Supplies or Pet Supplies Plus. Yo, this is a bitch too. Pre-employment drug screening. But yo, see, honestly, I'd be willing to do that. I would be willing to stop smoking just to get a job. Like, honest to God. Come on. Progress, bro. At least we're trying, you know? That's all you can do, right? All right, so this is the 3rd job we're applying to. This is Wawa. All right, there we go. So it looks like I have to take some assessment. 30 fucking minutes, Jesus Christ. I'm taking this assessment knowing I probably won't even get this job. But hey, bro, it's all in the effort, you know? Time to hit the post office.
It's on and on and on and on.
Stranger.
This is Tucker Bay Production.
All right, so right now it's currently like 6 o'clock p.m. As you guys can tell, 58 degrees out. Actually, not too bad. I think it's gonna be pretty cold tonight. I don't know. We might sleep in the tent again. I know I didn't upload a video yesterday, and that was just because I was super busy. The thing was, the tent video I didn't get to edit till the next day, so I was like one day off, you know what I mean? But no worries, because after this video, we're gonna be back on schedule. I'm just gonna try and post every day. Honestly, that's just my goal, is to post every single day. I don't know why, they just drive through the neighborhood with their sirens on. So random, bro, so random. I'm gonna try and scare Melissa, she's in the tent. Let's see if I can. This might not work. Damn, really? I didn't get you at all?
Bring the checkers or the cardboard. Good work.
Oh, wait.
Oh, shoot.
Okay, go get it.
Your
personal assistant has arrived, delivering you checkers and this big piece of fucking cardboard.
Smiling at my mama. But where what we sipping now? We was never tripping now. We on private jets, in other words, that means we tripping now.
wasn't it in the beginning. Nowhere to be found when I was down, but you show up when I'm winning.
It's honestly crazy, yo, but this whole entire folder here is literally just my court papers.
So this one is the police report for my DUI I got. This was 2/14/2020, so January 14th. It says I observed a 2013 blue Hyundai Sonata, which is my car, traveling southbound. Vehicle failed to stop at the posted stop sign at the intersection. I'm obviously cutting out the street names. I'm not going to say them, but then it says I caught up to the vehicle, which was stopped at the red light. The vehicle was completely over the white stop line. The vehicle then turned, the light then turned green, and the vehicle did not move from its stop position. The vehicle stayed stationary for 8 seconds. I then activated my emergency lights, sirens, in an attempt to pull the vehicle over. The vehicle did not move until our light turned red, which was approximately 16 seconds after I turned my emergency equipment on, 24 seconds total. The vehicle then proceeded through the intersection against the steady red signal while traffic was proceeding east-westbound. The vehicle then pulled over. I made contact with the operator of the vehicle, Mark. While speaking to him, I noticed his eyes were glassy and his speech was slurred. Once out of the vehicle, I detected an odor of alcoholic beverage emitting from his person. He failed all tests. For my personal contact with Mark and his performance on SFSTs, I've formed the opinion that Mark was under the influence of alcohol to a degree that rendered him incapable of safe driving. Upon checking Mark's information, I discovered that he is 20 years old. He was transported to county jail for purpose of a blood test. I observed blood being drawn from Mark's right arm at 23:22 hours on 2/14/2020. I received BAC results from the DUI center. His BAC was 0.15 on 2/14/2020 at 23:22 hours. Yo, this police report is crazy though, because the night I got my DUI, no lie, I'd been home and I was going back to New Jersey to visit my friend. And I literally drank, okay, I know it sounds crazy. I drank a Four Loko. Like, look, you should never drink and drive. This is obvious, right? You should not take a sip of beer and drive, right? I do not condone drinking and driving whatsoever. Like, don't do it. It's stupid. It's dumb. But the night I got my DUI, I drank a Four Loko, which is obviously a pretty high alcoholic beverage. And then 2 hours later, I drank a Corona. You know, obviously I was fucking intoxicated, but I wasn't like drunk. Like, you know, I'm used to drinking like liquor and like 12 beers. I'm not justifying what I did. I'm just saying, like, the fact that it says I ran a red light and was stopped, like, bro, this is so drawling. Like, that is the most drawling fucking shit I've ever read. Like, they're saying I sat at a green light, they turned on their sirens, and I still did not move. And then the light turned red, and then I want to see this dash cam footage, like, 125%, bro, because I know myself, like, I know I was drunk. I'm not, you know, like, guilty. I was definitely drunk, but that drunk, like, that is like blackout drunk. That is like stupid drunk.
I think there's somebody outside the tent. This may be the last video they ever made. Oh my God, I don't know what to do. Help me! Help me! Oh.